still can't believe Logan's the killer.
Well, one of them at least. I have a feeling whoever he's working with is the one in charge.
Why is that?
Well, if this was all about Logan and his obsession with serial killers, then what does any of this have to do with Grace? How would he even find out about the whole situation?
So, you don't think that Emma's the killer?
I doubt it. All this seems to go back to what you guys did to Grace. Speaking of which, can you check out Logan's Facebook page? Maybe there's some connection to Grace or her family.
Yeah. No, it says here that Logan went to school in Kansas. I mean, we went to the Valley. It's nowhere near Kansas.
So then if we find out who Logan's working with, it's most likely the person connected to Grace.
God, I would do anything to take back that Halloween.
Don't beat yourself over it, babe. Granted, what you did wasn't right, but what's done is done, and we'll face the consequences together.
I know, it's just so stressful.
I'm sure a date could relieve some of that stress. What do you say? Dinner tonight? You and me? What? What is it?
I'd love to. It's just, I don't think I'd be able to forgive myself.
Why is that?
Well, I couldn't leave Kristen alone, knowing that Logan and whoever's helping him are still out there somewhere.
Oh, no. Zoe, don't worry about me. I'll be fine. I'll go hang out with Arya. We'll make sure to lock up. And I won't open any doors when serial killers come knocking. Learn that the hard way.
You sure?
Yeah. I'm 18, not 8. I don't need a babysitter.
Okay. Well, in that case, yeah, I'd love to.
Awesome. You guys want to head back?
Yeah.
Hey. Just overheard the gang on campus talking about Grace. Speaking of which, is everything coming together for your plan tomorrow night? Good. Oh, by the way, Kyle and Zoe are going on a date tonight, which means that Arya and Kristen will be in the dorm. Seems like a perfect opportunity for a few more surprises before the grand finale tomorrow. All right. Good. Well, it seems like the perfect night for a bit of mischief.
Are you sure Kyle's gonna want to take you out to dinner in that dress? Looks like he'll want to just do you in the parking lot.
And I might just let him.
Oh my gosh, Zoe Cosgrove talking about sex. What does the world come to?
Is the question I've been asking myself every day since these murders started.
Tell me about it. I never thought that we'd be paying for something that we did in high school.
More like something Lauren did in high school. I mean, it's not like we ever willingly wanted to bully Grace. You know, Lauren was always dragging us into stuff like that. Never realized it was all for her benefit. I mean, she would have been nothing without us.
Yeah. While we always had each other.
Exactly.
Isn't that ironic?
What?
Lauren's dead. And we're paying for something that she made us do.
Well, as Lauren would say, that's immortality, my darlings.
I think that's Allie from PLL.
Lauren, Allie, same difference. Anyway, do you have the time on you?
Yeah, it's 5:25.
All right, I have to meet Kyle in 5. Hey, are you sure you're gonna be okay with just Arya here?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, well, I'll see you in a couple hours.
Bye. Have fun.
You look gorgeous.
Aw, thanks, babe.
I have a feeling tonight's gonna be like no other.
Agreed.
Zoe went on a date about an hour ago. With this guy, Kyle, she met him in our film class. Yeah, I'm happy for her. Oh, hold on, Mom. I'm getting a call on the other line. Who is this? Are you laughing? What's so funny?
Welcome, babe. I'm glad you had a fun time.
It's almost like I forgot what it's like to have fun.
Well, I'm glad I could help remind you. So, do you kiss on the first date?
You're such a dork, babe. Babe, what's wrong?
Myself to thee. Just make sure that you come alone. Everything will soon be known.
Sorry. They got Arya too.
Wait, what?
One of the killers came to our apartment and attacked me. And then Arya came over to help me and he went after her. So I ran down the hallway to the neighbors and I've been there for the past half hour or so.
You know what this means, right? The only two left. no. Wonder who that is. You're gonna pay for what you did to Kyle, asshole. Put her on speaker.
Ooh, I'm terrified. But I'm sure not nearly as terrified as you two are right now. Serial killer at large and no one to protect you. Sounds like tomorrow's gonna be one scary Halloween. Speaking of which, I'm sure by now you've received my invitation. So what do you say? Want to join me tomorrow for a little get-together?
Yeah, so we can walk right into your trap? No way.
Come on. I know you're dying to know who I am.
Yeah, but I'm not going to actually die for it.
Showing up is the least you can do for me.
Wait, what are you talking about?
You'll find out if you join me tomorrow.
Fine, we'll go if we can bring someone.
No! You and Kristen only. This is between me and you. No one else.
Fine. We'll be there.
Are you kidding? We can't go.
What other choice do we have with this? People have been dying because of us. Because of something that we did. We have to finally confront this, and running has done us no good whatsoever.
Yeah, I know, but we can find some other way to do it.
Nothing, Chris. I just watched my boyfriend get killed right in front of me. Parents are gonna never see their children again because of something that we did in high school. You know? If we have to pay for what we did, so be it. Maybe we deserve it.
You're right. I just hope we know what we're getting ourselves into. Who is that?
I think it's Grace.
Oh, look, there's another girl with her. I wonder who that could be.
That would be me.
Oh my God, stay back.
Don't worry, I'm not gonna kill you yet.
Who are you?
I'm a person who had something near and dear stripped away from them because bitches like you enjoy putting down others for your own amusement, even if it's at the expense of other people's lives. I assured that you guys wouldn't get away with what you did to Grace. I made sure that you guys would feel the same sense of loss I felt when you took my sister away from me, and all while being right under your noses the entire time.
Audrina!
What's wrong? You guys look like you've seen a ghost. Kristen, correct me if I'm wrong, but wasn't it you that said the dead don't come back to life?
But...
They can if they were never dead to begin with.
You were stabbed right in front of us.
No, you thought you saw me get stabbed. It's amazing in which the ways anatomy can teach you how to get stabbed without it being fatal.
So you're Grace's sister.
I was. But Grace was more than a sister. She was my best friend.
But wasn't Grace's last name Crawford? And isn't yours Dawson?
Crawford was my mom's maiden name. Dawson was my dad's last name. The same name everyone had in my family, except for Grace. See, for years, my parents neglected Grace, avoided her, treated her like a disease because she was mentally handicapped. They would send her to other schools, out of town, because they thought their mental development programs were better. When really, they just wanted her as far away from them as possible. But no matter where she went, she was bullied, online and at school. And despite plea after plea, my parents did nothing help her.
They were making fun of me today, and they call me Ginger.
Grace, I'm terribly busy right now. Talk to your father when he gets home. He should be home soon.
Dad!
Speak of the devil.
Dad, the kids are making
Grace, I've had a long day today.
Fun of me.
Some girl over at the high school killed herself, and I've been at the crime scene all day. Go talk to your sister about it. She should be home.
Hey, what's wrong, Grace?
Some kids were making fun of me today at school.
I'm sorry, sweetie. But you know what they say. It's not true, right? You know that.
I guess.
Have you told anyone?
I told Mom and Dad.
What did they say?
Mom was busy and Dad was tired. He said he was working a suicide case today. Is that what I have to do to make him pay attention to me, kill myself?
Don't say that, Grace. You know how much I love you. I don't know what I would do without you. I don't want to hear you say that ever again, okay?
Okay. You're doing the best.
What the hell, Mom? Grace tells you she was bullied at school and you tell her you're busy?
I'm busy. I have a 10 o'clock deadline for the story about the dangers of social media.
Oh, you want to talk about the dangers of social media? How about how Grace is bullied on social media every single day?
What? Are you suggesting I should interview her for my story? That's actually not such a bad idea.
You're unbelievable. You know, one day, you and Dad are gonna wish you did a lot more for her. I was the only one she could come to. The only one that cared for her. The only one that gave a damn. Because my dad was a police detective and my mom was a news journalist. All they cared about was the next big criminal and the next big headline. Oh my God, what happened?
You know those three girls I told you about?
That Lauren girl and her two friends?
They made fun of my costume today.
Oh, don't listen to them, your costume's great.
It's not, it's stupid.
It would be on anyone else, but it looks amazing on you. How about this? Go put your stuff down and I'll make you your favorite cup of Earl Grey tea.
Okay. Adrina?
Yeah?
I love you.
You love me too. That fall, things seemed to be getting worse. Until you two drove her to her breaking point and she couldn't take it anymore. Parents came home that day. They pretended to care. They pretended to be upset, but I knew it was a relief for them. My dad told the coroner it was an accident. And my mom, my own mom, wrote the news story, didn't even use our names. It was then that I would use their ignorance to my advantage. Because nobody knew what really happened. Nobody knew I was related to her. I could avenge Grace's death, and nobody would even think it was me. So I began planning.
I'm
riches that killed you will pay for all that they've done.
I figured I'd wait until you guys graduated college, and then we could do the whole time jump thing. But then, the perfect opportunity presented itself.
Police are currently looking for Emma Fitzgerald, one of the two people responsible for a series of murders at Fine Arts LA this past semester.
Are you kidding me? The girl involved with my sister's death found herself entangled in her own serial massacre. And not only that, but she survived! It was then I knew this was the perfect opportunity to get my revenge. Not only could I get my revenge, but everyone would think it was Emma. How perfect, right? And you guys got everything you deserved.
Audrina, we never meant to hurt your sister. We're sorry.
Sorry? Do you think sorry is gonna bring back the time I've had without her? The 3 years that I've experienced pain and loss without her? That's your problem, Zoe. You act all pure and innocent, when really, you're just as much as a bitch as Lauren was, if not worse. You see, Kristen and Lauren were two completely apathetic bitches who only cared about themselves. You knew what you're doing was wrong, but you still went along with it. In fact, you participated in it.
I tried to help your sister.
Clearly not enough. Because Lauren's friendship was much more important to you.
I understand you're upset about the way we treated Grace, but what does Logan have to do with all of this?
Have you seen any scary movie, like, ever? Hello? Every perfect killer has an accomplice. And I found the perfect one in Logan.
Hey.
Hey. So, you have any idea what movie we should do our project on?
Have real life. Then we're back. This whole thing feels like a sequel.
Yeah, I know, right? What if I told you Emma wasn't the killer?
Who else would be?
What if I told you I knew who the killer was?
Then I'd say you're full of shit. But my intrigue would definitely outweigh my doubt.
What if I told you I was the killer?
Then I would say you're definitely full of shit. But okay, I'll play along. Hypothetically, if you were the killer, what would your motive be?
Well, maybe some really bad people made my sister kill herself. And maybe I used the murders last year on campus as an opportunity to exact my revenge.
Hmm. Holy shit. But you're not joking.
No, I'm not. And I trust you'll keep it secret, unless you want to end up like Janet Leigh's character in Psycho.
That'll look too well in the shower. Wait, why are you telling me this? We just met today.
Coming from one mentally disturbed individual to another, I can just tell we have a lot in common.
How do you figure?
That whole film nerd shtick didn't make you the most popular guy in high school. In fact, I'm willing to bet that you were probably bullied, just like my sister was.
You're absolutely right. I used to relentlessly watch horror films, imagining I was one of those murder slashers, killing all those fucks who bullied me day after day.
Just like my sister.
We have a lot more in common than that.
Spill.
I
massacre. Last year, I was obsessed with the film Phantom Murders. Then when the killing started again, I figured, what's the point if Emma's back?
Hmm. Well, where you saw failure, I saw opportunity. I figure we can help each other out. Because no one knows better than you, a decent killer needs a good partner. And now, you would actually have a motive. Because killing without a motive is just psychotic.
I'm in.
All right. Well, if we're gonna do this, there's a few rules we have to follow. Rule number one, we have to act like we barely know each other.
You guys know each other?
Kinda. We're partners in Professor Loomis's presentation.
Oh, cool.
Rule number two, we have to kill everyone that those girls are close with.
Is that your boyfriend?
Yeah, he is. I'm so sorry, he just doesn't think sometimes.
I thought you said you were gonna stay in today.
I was, but then Amber made me realize that life goes on despite the fact that people die.
You know, depending on how much more intense things get, I might just take you up on that offer.
And rule number three, avoid suspicion at all costs.
Looks like I'm not the only horror expert.
I just made up that whole
number three, avoid suspicion at all costs. Is that why you faked your death?
Ding, 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 we have a winner. You see, my initial plan was to pretend to be your guys' best friend so that the betrayal of knowing I was the killer would hurt that much more. But then Detective Grayson went around asking too many questions.
I was at the library.
I was in class.
Which class was that?
Anatomy with Professor Carpenter.
Excuse me, Ms. Carpenter?
Yeah?
Hi, Detective Grayson.
Hi.
Hi, I was wondering if you could tell me if one of your students, Audrina Dawson, was in class the night of October 10th?
Let me check my roster. Let's see. It says here that Miss Dawson was absent from class that night.
All right. Well, thank you for your time.
I need to ask a favor from you. I need you to help me fake my own death. Yeah, my anatomy professor emailed me and asked if I was in any trouble. Apparently, Detective Grayson went around asking if I was in class the night of Amber's murder. Yeah. I know it wasn't my original plan, but I figured if I hang out with the girls, have some fun, and then get murdered in front of them, it'll be just as effective. All right, just give me about 2 hours, and then we'll do it then, okay? Okay, thanks.
I was wondering if you wanted to have a movie night.
Yeah, I'm in.
Yeah, sure, me too.
Okay, awesome.
Logan dragged my body away and bought bandages for my wound. I've been staying at an abandoned house down the street from campus this whole time. So you see, everything has worked perfectly up to this moment. And now that you know everything about my sister, I think it's time that you experience the same fate as she.
You aren't gonna get away with this.
You aren't gonna get away with this. Yeah, I am. I'm supposed to be dead, remember? The whole country thinks Emma's the killer. And in about 5 minutes, you're gonna be dead too. See, what's gonna happen is Logan's gonna come waltzing through that door. We're gonna kill you both. And then when the cops come, Logan's gonna be the quote unquote sole survivor. And he's gonna blame Emma Fitzgerald for everything. The hunt for the infamous Emma Fitzgerald continues. Oh, Logan!
You
You got Chris? I got Zoe.
Of Kristen and Kyle and I.
You know, they say the first holiday without someone's always the worst.
Yeah, well, I can definitely vouch for that. You know, I just try my best not to think about that night. I mean, it was almost 2 months ago, but it kind of feels like it just happened yesterday.
Well, at least they caught Adrina, unlike Emma, who they still haven't found.
Yeah, you know, I still don't like the idea of her being in a sanitarium. She should be in a prison. You know, who knew that obsessive insanity was a liable defense?
Well, she is obsessive. And insane, so that's probably why. Look, sanitariums are just as secure as jails. She's not getting out of there, trust me.
Yeah, I know, you're right.
I know I am. Listen, you want some advice?
Sure.
Girls like us, we only do the best we can. Sometimes we make it, sometimes we fake it, but we get one step closer each and every day, and we figure it out on the way.
Wait, isn't that the Lizzie McGuire theme song?
Can't say I didn't try.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, guys.
You guys want to open some presents?
Let's do it.
The Grinch steal Christmas?
No.
This one's yours.
Thank you.
Seriously, a book, guys. A theme.
Thank you. Hey, guys, I just want to say, you know, despite everything that happened this semester, I'm really glad that you guys are my roommates. You know, it almost feels like everything's back to normal. And I just want to say thank you for that.
Glad we can help.
Yeah, if you need anything, we're here for you.
Thanks.
Hey, who's this from?
Let me see. to be fucking kidding me.
The events of the last 2 years here at Fine Arts LA. Administration and staff are looking to start fresh this school year and are hoping that nothing like that ever occurs again. Police now have no reason to believe that Emma Fitzgerald was involved with the massacre that took place last year. And considering she has not been cited within the past year or so, police now believe Ms. Fitzgerald may have fled the country or died attempting to flee the country. Here's hoping that there are no psychopaths looking to slaughter any students here this year at this fine university. Although it would make for an interesting news story. Back to you at the studio, Ron.
Are they talking about the murders that happened here?
Yeah.
God, that is scary. I hope nothing like that happens again. My mom almost didn't let me go here because of those murders.
I'm sure we'll be fine. Trilogies are so cliche.
Yeah, but everything has a trilogy nowadays.
All we can do is hope that this isn't one of those times.
Seriously. Well, I gotta go to class. I'll see you later.
All right, later.